Have you ever wondered why life expectancy in two neighboring counties differs? How does raising the minimum wage affect health? Are laws regulating youth sports having an impact on traumatic brain injury? How do we determine what effect a law has on health, whether it's good, bad, or none at all? As we will discuss in this video, the answers to these questions can be determined through the practice of legal epidemiology. But you may be wondering, what exactly is legal epidemiology? Legal epidemiology is the scientific study and deployment of law as a factor in the cause, distribution, and prevention of disease and injury in a population. So what distinguishes legal epidemiology from other legal research methods? Legal epidemiology provides a scientific approach to studying the impact and effectiveness of laws on health. Consider, for example, laws that ban texting while driving. The general hypothesis might be that once a state passes a law implementing this ban, the number of car crashes will decrease. This hypothesis can be proved or disproved through legal epidemiology. Studying the law through a scientific lens is very different from the way lawyers analyze law in traditional legal research. Legal research typically focuses on assessing how a rule may be applied to a particular situation, and it typically focuses on current law. Compare that approach with the foundational principles shown on this slide. Legal epidemiology is scientific in its approach. Systematic. Transparent. Replicable. Precise. That is, it demonstrates rigorous quality control. And finally, it's measurable. In other words, it was created to be evaluated. Now let's discuss the different elements of legal epidemiology. The first element we'll discuss is legal etiology. Legal etiology is the study of laws and legal practices as causes of disease and injury. When it comes to shaping health outcomes and societal behavior, law has two important roles. First, law helps build and maintain the social, economic, and physical worlds where we live, learn, work, and play. Second, law acts as a mechanism for changing social and economic structures, and these changes can affect the distribution of health in a population. For example, the health outcomes for a person with low income is shaped by specific experiences with legal rules, institutions, and agents. These experiences may be quite different from the experiences of people with high income. A second element of legal epidemiology is legal prevention and control, the study of laws and legal practices as causes of disease and injury. Legal prevention and control explore how law shapes health systems and institutions, and how it can be used as a tool of intervention. Let's think about how to study legal health interventions like seatbelt laws. What effect do those laws have on safety and car crashes? Legal prevention and control also include what we call infrastructural law, which governs a health department's powers, duties, jurisdiction, and organization. Consider the example of comparing health outcomes in jurisdictions with and without rulemaking boards of health. A third element of legal epidemiology is policy surveillance, the ongoing systematic collection, analysis, and dissemination of information about laws and other policies important to health. Policy surveillance is related to both legal etiology and legal prevention and control. It also directly serves advanced research methods that systematically analyze how laws and policies affect health over time and across jurisdictions. Take, for example, the effects of laws related to traumatic brain injury in youth sports across jurisdictions and over time. The first law of this kind was enacted in 2009. And since then, every state has passed a similar law. These laws are ripe for policy surveillance and advanced legal epidemiology methods to determine whether they are effectively reducing brain injuries in young athletes. All three of these elements help to identify and evaluate evidence-based legal solutions to public health problems and facilitate the diffusion of effective legal strategies. Let's make a comparison. It is universally accepted that a prescription medication should not be used on patients until that drug has been properly tested. The medication needs to be both safe and effective. Laws, by contrast, are commonly applied in large doses to millions of people without any testing. But laws and policies, like prescription medication, are treatments. It is important to know whether they work, as well as what their side effects are, whether good or bad. Legal epidemiology is the field devoted to this inquiry. If you're interested in learning more, we encourage you to check out our free Legal Epidemiology training series, which takes a deeper dive into what legal epidemiology is, introduces legal mapping, and covers advanced research methods. This training is part of the Public Health Law Academy, which is supported by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC. Our free and easy-to-use trainings provide a deeper understanding of the use of law and policy to improve population health outcomes. Developed in cooperation with ChangeLab Solutions, the online trainings offered by the Public Health Law Academy are essential for all public health professionals. To learn more, visit www.publichealthlawacademy.org. The views expressed in this video, including written training materials or publications, do not necessarily reflect the official policies of CDC or the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, nor does the mention of trade names, commercial practices, or organizations imply endorsement by the U.S. government. Like all materials associated with the Public Health Law Academy, this video provides legal information but not legal advice, and no attorney-client relationship is created. Please contact an attorney in your state if you need legal advice. Furthermore, the information provided in this video is for informational purposes only and does not constitute legal advice. ChangeLab Solutions does not enter into attorney-client relationships. And while every effort has been made to verify the accuracy of these materials, legal authorities and requirements may vary from jurisdiction to jurisdiction. The contents of this presentation have not been formally disseminated by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and should not be construed to represent any agency determination or policy. Always seek the advice of an attorney or other qualified professional on any questions you may have about a legal matter.